What is going on, everyone? Hyperspy Gaming here, and today I'm back with another episode of the Top 5 series, and I'm definitely excited to continue this. This is our third episode, and you guys show a lot of support on these series, and you guys show that you liked it, so I'm gonna continue it. Hopefully, my goal is to like maybe get this series to like episode 100, get it in those high numbers. I think it would be pretty cool, so hopefully we could get it up there soon. But other than that, our topic will on this episode will be top 5 scariest maps on Call of Duty Zombies. So that's what we'll be talking about today. Also, if you entered for the giveaway that I posted maybe like 2 videos back, I think I will be announcing the winners through the end of the video. So if you entered, don't exit the video after I finish talking about the top 5, because I will be announcing the 2 winners that won this giveaway, and I will be showing you guys who it is, and I'll be telling you guys what's gonna happen basically. So stay tuned for that. But other than that, let's get right into today's video. Coming in 5th in our top 5 for today's video will be Shinonuma from World at War. And basically, you spawn in house, there's swamp all around you. The entire place is pretty foggy. You know, there's dead bodies hanging everywhere, and it's a pretty creepy themed map. The map in and of itself is pretty difficult. When you step in the swamp, you slow down, which makes you more vulnerable. And you can't really form a strategy in the map, because you don't know where the perks are gonna be. The perks are spawned randomly, so you can't really form a strategy and say like, you know, I'm gonna buy this, do this, get to high rounds, which makes it more difficult, which makes the map technically more scarier. Coming in at number 4, we have Vrukt, also from World at War. And just like Shinonuma, there's a lot of fog in this map. When you spawn, the players are basically separated by a door, which will only open when you turn on the power. So you always have to turn on the power to be together, which makes the map much more difficult. The theme of the map is pretty creepy as well. As I said, there's a lot of fog. There is one room where there's like, it's a kitchen, and then there's like a butcher knife, you know, there's blood everywhere. So it's pretty creepy. There's also a place where there's like coffins, and one of the coffin places, it's empty, and it shows like blood stain, like someone dragged the dead body out. So it's pretty creepy. The map is very difficult. There's no real training spot, especially in co-op. In solo, maybe you could like find a small place, you could go to high rounds, but in co-op it's pretty difficult. And honestly, I just think that it has one of the worst box places. But yeah, this map is pretty creepy, and that's why it is a number 4 on today's top 5. Coming in at number 3, we have a map from Black Ops 1, Shangri-La. It is a pretty creepy map. It's pretty cool though. It's one of the more exciting maps. It's not dull at all. You're basically in a jungle, there's a temple, there's different types of zombies. Like there's a napalm zombie where when it explodes, when you get near it, it explodes, and if you don't have jug, you're basically dead. There's a screaming zombie, which I don't know what it's called, but he runs really fast, and when he screams, your entire screen gets blurry, and it makes it difficult. But the map is pretty creepy. Like I said, it's in a jungle. There's an old temple. The zombies are pretty creepy. There's this one zombie where it's like, it's bald, but like it has this giant head, and it's pretty creepy. There's like bodies on fire everywhere. You know, it's a pretty cool map, but it's also creepy, which is why Wave makes it in our number 3 spot. Coming in at number 2, we have a map from Black Ops 2, which is Mall of the Dead. And if you guys have played this map, you would know that I don't have to say anything for you guys to know that this map is creepy. As you guys can see on the screen, it's 4 prisoners in Alcatraz that try to escape. Now they realize that the entire island is basically everyone in the island is turned into zombies, and now they're trying to survive. The map is set at night, which makes it much more creepier. The entire map is kind of gothic theme. The entire place is filled with like melting candles, and there's these hellhounds that you have to feed to get this wonder weapon. And you feed them with zombies, basically you kill the zombies and then they eat it. This map is pretty simple in terms of like high rounds. It's pretty easy, but it's still fun. And what makes this map really creepy is that the zombies' eyes are red, which means that the devil is controlling them, so that's pretty creepy. But that is why this is number 2 on our list. Coming in at number 1, we have the scariest map of all zombies in my opinion, and that is a map from World at War, later remade in Black Ops 1, and the map is Nostrum Totem. If you guys haven't played this map or haven't seen it, the map is very small. There's only 2 floors and a 1 box place, no perks. But in Black Ops 1 there was Mule Kick, but that's still not very good. The map was set at like nighttime. It was very foggy. There were like barrels on fire everywhere. It was just a very scary map, and one of the best maps of all Call of Duty Zombies. But that is why this is the scariest map in Call of Duty Zombies. That is all for today's video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, leave a like if you enjoyed this series and want me to continue it. And if you enjoyed this video in specific, also feel free to like. Also, if you have any ideas, you could comment them down below. I will be looking at them. You know, I really want to put content that you guys want to see, so I'll be looking at those. And subscribe if you already haven't, and so you won't miss out anything, you know, because as I'm gonna announce the winners right now, I'll be doing more giveaways soon later on. So if you guys want that, you can subscribe, you know, and you'll know when to like enter for a giveaway if I make any. And I'll be making more top 5 videos and like any other videos you guys want, so you can keep up with that. As for the giveaway, the 2 winners are, first one is Crazy Scree or Scry Kitty. I'm sorry if I can't pronounce your name, I don't know. You asked for a PSN card, and I'll be DMing you that very soon. So congratulations to you. The second person is Clean Reaper, who asked for an Xbox card. I'll be DMing you that as well. I will also be subscribing and following you guys, as I said in the giveaway. So congratulations to you both. And I just want to personally thank all of you guys, not just the winners. I know there's more people that watch me and support me. I just want to thank you all for getting me this far, basically, and you know, watching my videos all the time. I know I don't upload way too often, but if I could, I would. And I try to upload every, you know, every opportunity I get. So yeah, thank you guys. I'll be doing more giveaways soon. I don't know when, I'm not sure. But if you also have any ideas of what I could do for a giveaway, you could also comment down below. But that is all for today's video, guys. Thank you for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one.
Peace!